As I tell a lot of my fares, I start at 4, wake up at 6. All right, I have to find a cab. I lost my job as an exotic dancer. I mean, you come out of the slammer, no place to live. Got a history of drugs. Where else was I gonna go? Really, they thought I fit right in. I think the thing to do is I'm gonna pull the cab out of the lot and go park it. And then we should have a conversation with Jaime and and Lucian Watsons.
Okay.
And Manuel. All right. But I want to get the cab out of the lot. All right. So, by the way, heads up everybody, because of all the cabs and all the traffic around here, and you probably know that. I probably didn't have to say that. I just want to introduce you to two of the best guys around. Jaime, Manuel, fabulous. They do a great job, always in good spirits. Jaime, you can't get the smile off his face. And Manuel, this is my friend Bob and Sylvia. These guys do brake jobs in the middle of the night, fix tires, babysit for the drivers who come in whining. You're actually ready for this?
Something wrong.
Rich, how you doing? It is a funny business. I mean, you can't make all the money in the world. It just is, you know, you can do what you can do. I pick up these two guys, they're musicians from New York. The guy introduces himself as Dude, and this is my side man, Subdude. All right, straight ahead. Probably end up spending twice as much money for gas a month than your rent. We have those portable bathrooms because they're redoing the bathrooms at Luxor, and they're brutal. I wouldn't send anybody in there. I mean, rather than Guantanamo, that's what they should do, just make people spend 10 minutes in those portable bathrooms.
Hey, how's the heart attack?
I haven't had one in a while. No, actually, the whole condition is very stable. Last time I saw my cardiologist, she's listening to my heart with the stethoscope and looks up at me and says, boring. You gotta be regular to have regulars. It's April Fool's Day.
Mm-hmm.
The baseball season starts today.
Yes.
The Final Four basketball tournament will be completed tomorrow.
Now that I didn't know.
My baseball fantasy league draft is tomorrow.
Oh, is that the dinner, the banquet?
No, that happens at the end of the year, where they announce that we finished last.
Well, you may not finish last.
Nah,
your fantasy league won't, for sure.
No, I don't think we're going to finish last this year. I mean, you can't lose them all. I hate to see it. You know, one of Red's housemates passed away. This is Ralph Edward Herring.
From?
From Missouri.
Fulton, Missouri.
Fulton, Missouri.
Where Winston Churchill and Harry Truman came in 1946.
A nice ensemble.
Yeah, well, I think I'm three hats today. It'll be a nice Sunday. Ouchie.
I bought Red the cowboy hat.
Okay.
For
Halloween.
For a Halloween.
Halloween. Okay.
All right, so now it turned out it was a little big. So what he wore as a gasket was a Marilyn Monroe wig. But, so you're one Marilyn Monroe wig short today, Red.
I know. He's an excellent cab driver. Very considerate. Patient. I don't get that too many cab drivers. How did I get you, Dennis?
You've never had me, and I don't even want you to start your rumors like that.
Well, this is the time to start that rumor.
Red, Red has a lot of medical things he has to take care of.
My doctor, Kenneth Mills, he says, Ed, you are my miracle child. Your CD count is 1,133, viral load undetectable. You see, I've been on the cocktail, a protease inhibitor, for 10 years.
Wow.
And it's saved my life.
Once part of a group that tried to buy the Baltimore Orioles. They were rolling in dough. But also, it contributed to unhappiness. Money is not everything, I'll tell you that. I want to say can't buy me love, but that's not true. I think as a cab driver, my strength is bedside manner.
Oh, that driver, I figured that out.
Oh, it's gonna be a long, hot summer with a fat lip. I went to this poor guy at Billy's funeral, you know, and this memorial that they had for him. I looked around the room and I thought, oh God, the drugs that were done out of this group. I mean, literally, tons. God knows how I survived that. Still, I don't know. Mystical, magic. If I was having any kind of a life, I would say I was blessed. But it's not applicable.
I think getting busted saved your ass?
Probably.
I'm an ex-heroin addict, and
You're not alone.
I'm going up here to Bart Clinic, and there'll be some real characters in this line up here. Tom, tell him about the methadone clinic and how it works while I dose, all right?
Okay.
All right, let him know.
How it works. Well, first of all, you have to become a drug addict. And when that happens, you get tired of the lifestyle you're living and you come to a place like this and you they give you a synthetic a narcotic and you drink it as long as you feel until you feel better and feel like you can make it without it.
I don't know how I can really explain the feeling that a person has that has an addiction problem. It's something that a lot of people in this country have, and they don't really know how to deal with the people that are struggling with their issues or the pain that they have inside.
I came home from Nam, and it wasn't, it was better then, but the heroin was good too. But now, the heroin sucks, and you may go to bed one night and your arm is coming off, you know? So I best thing to do is get on methadone, you know?
Well, I did 13 21-day detox programs. That was like a vaccination that never took, you know? And then I got on maintenance, but from the day I got on, I mean, I knew that this wasn't gonna be a long association, and I was determined to get off as soon as I got on.
Well, I've been on this stuff for 38 years.
I'm not on detox, I'm on maintenance, because I know if I don't have this, I'll be back on heroin.
We all just have to basically work real hard on each other and, you know, make things work, because the way we're going now, we're all going to get picked off one at a time as an addict and die.
Driving a celebrity around, huh? Dennis, all right. Mr. Bear Aspen. How you doing?
I'm having the time of my life. How about you, Howard?
You got a letter? What's going on?
No, I'm driving
a cab.
I
knew you went.
I know. I knew me when, too.
That's a guy I was in jail with.
Was it?
Yes.
Hey, Dennis, is this the methadone clinic you used to go to?
No. But I went to a
Ford Help, right?
No, a sister clinic, Bart Market.
I liked it better when this clinic was up on Gary, because you didn't have to come down here. Because right in here is a big major heroin and crack dealing place down here.
This neighborhood is brutal. I went into this drug program to clean up, you know, and I learned to cop in every ghetto in the United States. I learned it. I made more connects. This drug program. You know, I let these people know that this does not have to be a lifetime ordeal. That it's absolutely possible to get off. But it's not easy, I really mean it. As you begin to diminish your dose, one's body really takes a beating. She goes and leaves flowers on her husband's grave, her father's grave, and the cat's grave. I asked her if the cat was Jewish. And she looked at me. I said, well, cats, it's a Jewish name. Diana, how are you? So-so, huh?
No, good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm thinking in the morning that I will not can come. So, wait a minute.
Yeah, no, take your time.
Because my movement is so badly. Monday is the Seder, real Seder.
Mm-hmm.
And I go to my niece, you was once, on Fulton and Third.
Uh-huh.
You remember?
Yeah, you know, yes. What time are you going Monday?
I think 6 o'clock.
6 in the evening?
Yes.
I might be able to give you a ride.
Oh, good.
Yeah. She doesn't realize, you know, if I didn't need the money, I would drive her for free. She's just such a dear. So now we're going to the farmer's market, right?
Yes, to farmer.
On Hyde Street.
Here on, where is the library?
Yeah,
Yes.
But by Civic Center.
I don't know the name of the...
By Civic Center.
Yes.
Yes.
You don't get good. It's in this side.
No, everything's good. Oh, it's on Hyde Street.
Here?
Yeah, yeah.
Uh-huh,
have I ever failed you? I mean,
no,
honestly,
no,
never.
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 It's not displayed. They are not here, the people out here. I need to found out the stones.
Okay, I'm coming.
He heard 5 pounds at first. Okay.
If she said half pound, I heard a half pound.
Yes, you know what?
That's it.
All you gotta say is, all you gotta know is two words. Yes, dear.
Yes.
Exactly. I don't know. As we go into Chinatown, on the left-hand side, you're going to see this Israeli cafe. And this is really... And he bought several cases of Manischewitz wine, and it's a table wine in this Chinese restaurant. I thought, oh, yikes. I have these three gay women in a car. I got a chance to use my best line. Where to, lesbos? Really, it whacked me with a newspaper. Sign of the times. I mean, that used to, you could get in trouble then, but now it was funny. Yeah, the human jukebox. You put money in, and this flap opens up in the jukebox, and he gives you an ounce of pot. He's got caught on Fisherman's Wharf, selling to a cop. God, that bus looks like it came from Bangalore. Dave has this idea that
okay.
Where to go, and I would say we'll listen to him. I just have, I have so much regard for this guy because I know what he does with his spare time is he really looks after the cab drivers. Try it.
If you're a day driver, you pick up a lot of folks who go to the need to go to the doctor. Business people go into the airport, and so you get to serve those people. Also, San Francisco is a beautiful city, and just by osmosis, you're gonna pick up on the beauty. There's another form of beauty too, which is this is the birthplace of the United Nations, and there's a lot of karma here, and the charter was signed in June of 1945 in the Veterans Building, right next to the Opera House.
And that was in answer to the question of how long you've been driving a cab.
Yeah,
now
you ask another question. Hey, Dennis, how long you've been driving a cab?
About 6 years total.
It's early. It's only the third inning.
So, by the speaking of the end, what are the A's doing? Are the A's playing the Giants again today?
They are.
So you're going to share the back seat with Sylvia. And behave yourself.
Good day, troops.
Hey, Red.
All right, so we're going to Clipper and where?
Sanchez.
Clipper and Sanchez, yes.
My psychiatrist said, from what little I told him about my parents and my brother and my background, that sex was never discussed at the dinner table or anywhere. Taboo. So now that I'm an adult, I say foul words sometimes.
All right, so tell me this, Red. Are you actually going to go to church?
Welcome.
We're the only all accepted. There was a like a drag queen or a transgender. We used to meet down in Valencia, and before the service, she'd be on her haunches, have a mirror, shave and a beard, man's beard. And she'd say she'd be in Safeway or a bus stop, and little kids would nudge her, "Mom, it's just him." "Mama, what's that?" "It's a man trying to look like a woman." Sabrina.
Hi. Tastefully staying off the Mercedes. Oops. God, I did a better job than I thought.
Killer.
She's really such a sweetie.
What's her name?
Angela.
I should keep myself straight about this one. She's 27 years old, and I'm not so spoiled or selfish. I've already had a life. But she really is a charmer, and I love hanging out with her. But honestly, it's out of regard for her. I'm 63 years old. I'm not the guy for her.
You got a late start?
We're cougars in training. Cougars in training. How are you?
Great. You guys cutting across? You taking a shortcut here?
Basically. We're just looking for some young men to coug out with.
We're chicken hawks.
You know what a cougar is, right?
Somebody who eats a chicken hawk?
No.
No, we are chicken
older
hawks.
Older ladies that go for a younger man. Does it make you hot? Oh, sorry. We love you. Look at our tails.
Can we go to Pacific between Jones and Taylor?
Pacific between Jones and Taylor.
Yeah, yes. Are you getting my tattoo?
I was hoping we were going to say Reno.
Candace Beta Breakers.
It's enough information. For me, I'm old. The candle's flickering.
You know, we think, you know, you can have a drink a little and then burn off the calories you're drinking.
The race gets easier as you go because you're no longer holding 2 6-packs.
Right.
Please, can we get in the back? We need to get over to the race.
Well,
how many
of you are?
As many as you can fit. Can we just please get a ride over there?
Break, go, fade up, break, here go.
We need you to fade up. Breakers, drive us, please.
Let us in the car. I'm not going to lie, I'm wearing a singlet.
We need to go to Bay of the Breakers. Ahorita, right now. Right now, right now. We need to go.
We're lost.
You're lost.
I just went way off the hook with methadone and then smoked crack on top of it.
The methadone just took the edge off and you added a little crack
it's going for that medical speedball.
Almost from the first day I met Ryan, I thought, this is a cowboy who's, down deep, really a nice guy.
Yeah.
And by the way, that was nice to meet your girlfriend.
Yeah, she's sleeping.
She's really all right. I'm proud of you. This is the good news.
Yeah. I don't get aggressive around her. She goes, you're not going to get violent around me. I don't even want to see you mad. I was like, all right, so I have to watch what I say. And all that. But that's a good thing, though. Yeah. From being out here in this concrete jungle for so long. See, Dad committed suicide when she was 12. She lived in the National Hotel when she was like 12, 13. And then she went to the Darwin, and she went to the Civic Center. All is as a minor, this lady that owned all those hotels became like her guardian or whatever. As one hotel got off the hook and it wasn't safe for my girlfriend Rebecca, she'd move her. She used to live right here at the Civic Center Hotel. She was up there one day and she showed me the room that she lived in, and this guy named Benny that we both know pushed another guy right out the window onto the floor as the lady who owns all these hotels was walking up. I said, how long did that last? How long did you stay in the hotel? She said about 2 more days. You know, shit changes.
Ah, but she seems like a solid citizen.
She is a solid citizen. She's good for me.
Yeah, absolutely. Driving down on the Embarcadero. I mean, if the weather's really nice, the stretch is so jam-packed, it's really hard to negotiate. And yes, there are fares, but it's no fun driving. And God knows I'm not in driving a cab to make money. To make a little money and have a good, and enjoy myself. Take advantage of the low overhead in my life. Kevin, it's going good. We won big yesterday. Yeah, it's funny. That's 3 different versions. I had us losing 38-31. Mumford had us losing 38-32. So, yeah, same neighborhood. But we won big yesterday. Andrew Jones, he hit a home run. We played in the Huskow. Yeah, I mean, honestly, we were on a ranch. The dorm, as it were, was only about, was less than 100 feet from the, from home plate. We literally rolled out of the dorm onto the baseball diamond. Place was sort of meant for me. Girl, how you fix your softballs?
I got some. How many you need?
Probably a couple.
A couple? All right, you want them down?
No. As long as they're in the bag, as they say.
All right, Paul.
And they're paying me off. This is a big payoff. Watch this. See
really?
That? Now, they never lose a game. Even as bad as they are. I love you guys. You guys take care.
All right, thanks, Merle. I appreciate it very much.
The payoff's been made.
So, Dennis, you finally got some balls, huh?
Hey, who's the comic here?
Sure, I'm not taking the plastic off.
One down.
Ever.
One down.
So, Dennis, you got any special preparations for the game or what?
No, usually I bring my oxygen bottle, but special preparations, yeah, we throw the ball around a little.
Dennis has been around long enough, though. He gets out of the sack warm.
Last out, buys the beer. So that's week. Why I have tactically not penciled myself in a lineup.
So how long have you been playing ball with Dennis?
30 years.
Wow. Incredible.
Hate to admit it.
Really? Has it gotten worse or what?
Oh, yeah, he's gotten worse. His skills of he used to be a 5-tool player, now he's a no-tool player.
So what do you got?
But he has aged. But he has aged. Yeah. Gracefully at that.
Yeah, well, once upon a time, we had a fabulous team. We have a very good team now for a bunch of geezers. You'll see. I mean, we can play. I'm the flaw.
We got Ray, Mike Malone, Kim Malone, Steve Smith, John Graz, Aaron, and Dennis Breit's regular cameo for, Aaron.
All right, you can't be out here, Bob. It's dangerous. That's our pitcher. He's left-handed.
Can't trust lefties, huh?
Precisely. Look at Stalin.
That's out of play!
This is worth it. I mean, this just calling balls and strikes is a show in itself.
Hi. This is Sue. Except I had a big old mahogany desk. Walked in, I had to sit in the lobby before I got a chance to see him. Showed me in to see Mr. Breit. And we sat down, we talked baseball.
Was that my name? Mr. Breit? Oh,
yeah. We talked baseball for an hour, and we've been fast friends ever since.
That's right.
Been some good times.
Here we go, start us
Not too many base hits, but some good times.
It's brutal.
All right, Ray Buck.
Yeah. Oh, no, I told you I was going to tell you this deaf joke. Oh, I did tell you that, right?
Right.
What's this?
What's that?
Pasteurized milk. Pasteurized milk. And you're legal for pot. I mean, it's nothing. And they're legal, I'm sure. They're licensed to sell it.
Of course.
If I didn't have such a checkered past, I think I would be in the pot club business.
It makes you mellow, you know. Kind of worries can fly away a little more.
Oh, that's...
Relieves stress. Stress kills.
Oh, you got the... Got the slogans down. Stress kills. Give me pot. No appetite. Give me pot. What else?
See, I always have an appetite, so I can't use that as an excuse.
You mean?
My ex said I just want it for recreational purposes.
And?
I didn't give him an
answer.
What would
that be? When you're ski jumping?
When you're horny and want to play around. And it always takes two to tango.
Oh, I got it. Okay.
It's called Granddaddy XO. That's the best probably in the city.
Do Do you remember that plastic bottle you gave me from the pot club?
Yeah.
I had to give a urine specimen. It's almost identical to the other jar. Really? And I filled the one from the pot club and brought it in. I know.
Oh, yeah, that was good.
So, yes, except the lab looks at the jar and says, you're not shooting, are you? All right, so I'm going to see you tomorrow. I'll drop that lighter off.
Okay. Thanks,
guys. So I heard this discussion about George Bush and his brother Jeb. You know, as they relate to their father, Herbert Walker Bush, you know, and somebody said that George Bush W's nickname was the evil of two lessers. And there you have it. That was secure at our toe. Put myself in a position where I could lose that place. I mean, I had a lifetime lease on it. I was leading the life of Riley. No substitute for experience. I mean, what an experience. Really, CEO. I had a Q clearance once upon a time. You know, I toured Lawrence Livermore Lab. It showed me all the happenings out there. And then Pelican Bay.
We got a couple of great bridges in the city. The Golden Gate Bridge. We got the Bay Bridge. Those are sister bridges, by the way. Bay Bridge, 1936. Golden Gate, May of 1937. And so this is a memorial over here to what happened across the street at the Autofred building over there. And these are the guys who did the real lifting, the real work like Dennis does. Sits on his butt in the cab, takes the people to the hospital, takes the old lady to the graveyard, and then they want to screw him out of his benefits, miniaturize the benefits, compartmentalize it, have the corporations, the taxi corporations, wash their hands of any responsibility towards the people who bring the money to the window and pay for their wives, their kids, and so forth. Just as a wild and crazy thought. That's what's going on.
Dennis is one of a kind. I even said that when Rebecca was in the car. Yeah, Dennis, I would have never thought about it the first time I jumped in his cab. I would have never thought about it.
When are you going to quit smoking? Man?
Today. This is my last day of smoking.
Okay, can we tell your cardiologist that?
Absolutely. I'm going to see my doctor on Wednesday, and I want to look her in the eye and say I quit.
Even if you're lying?
No, I won't lie to her. I can't.
Why, right, she's your lifeline?
Nah, she just has so much integrity, and I have to say, she's probably got more invested in my health than I do.
What's this is all about?
Methadone, man.
Methadone?
What do you think about methadone?
Well, it's better than that heroin. The heroin they bring across the border is full of valve infection. and it's killing people. You know what I'm saying? You shoot that stuff in your arm, the next thing you know, your arm will fall off. So I suggest everybody stay away from that heroin.
Hey, Dennis.
Yeah?
What was the deal with the guy who we drove to the methadone clinic? What was his name?
Ryan.
Ryan.
Yeah, where'd I just picked him up as a fare one day. And I told him I was a graduate. He has since the cable car is off the cable. In fact, he's missing in action. He hadn't been home in days. But even before he'd been missing, I mean, he really, he gave up his program.
I will call you to tell you precisely what hour.
Uh-huh.
Yes?
Yeah, no, it was, no problem.
Oh, good. Good.
Have you ever heard Denny play the piano?
Oh, yeah.
He's an accomplished pianist, almost.
Rockman
enough. Yeah. Verdi.
Chopin.
Tchaikovsky.
So there's an incredible convergence of things happening now.
Uh-huh.
Today is Palm Sunday, right?
Yes.
Passover's tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And
happy Pesach.
Today, thank you. That's like saying happy Ramadan.
What do you think, Bob?
What's that?
Well, no, here.
Put it under his jacket?
Yeah, we'll see if it works. So oh, coffee. Here. Good, good. A funny thing happened to me on the way down here tonight. A man fell out of a three-story window and landed right at my feet. I bent over and I said, "What happened, pal?" He says, "I don't know, I just got here myself."
That's real good, Dennis.
Talking about cowboys. Two cowboys are sitting on a fence. One cowboy says to the other, he says, "Say, Tex, are you really from Texas?" He says, "No, I'm from Louisiana." He said, "Why do they call you Tex?" He says, "I shoot the first guy who calls me Louise."
Nice, Dennis. Real good.
All right, how do you drink from these?
Okay.
An ugly baby that when I was born, the doctor slapped my mother. I hopped in the cab and told him to take me where the action was. He took me to my house. My wife likes to talk to me after sex. Now she calls me from hotels.
Nice, Dennis. Real nice.
I have this philosophy, if you're going to spend a couple of minutes with me, I'm going to leave you laughing. And I really mean it. And I want to cheer myself up. Honest, I never want this job to be drudgery.
So that means you can keep smoking?
Not exactly. She's threatened to strangle me. She said, "Your smoking is really dangerous for your health." I said, "Really?" She said, "Yeah, because I'm going to strangle you if you don't stop." Not that interesting, huh? Here comes baseball. As I tell a lot of my fares, I start at 4, wake up at 6. All right, I have to find a cab.
I lost my job as an exotic dancer. I mean, you come out of the slammer, no place to live. You know, got a history of drugs. Where else was I gonna go? Really, they thought I fit right in.
I think the thing to do is I'm gonna pull the cab out of the lot and go park it. And then we should have a conversation with Jaime and whatchamacallit, and who's and what's it's, and Manuel. All right, but I want to get the cab out of the lot. All right. So, by the way, heads up everybody, because of all the cabs and all the traffic around here, and you probably know that. I probably didn't have to say that. I just want to introduce you to two of the best guys around. Jaime, Manuel, fabulous. They do a great job, always in good spirits. Jaime, you can't get the smile off his face. And Manuel, this is my friend Bob and Sylvia. These guys do brake jobs in the middle of the night, fix tires, babysit for the drivers who come in whining. You're actually ready for this? Rich, how you doing? It is a funny business. I mean, you can't make all the money in the world. It just is, you know, you can do what you can do.
I pick up these two guys, they're musicians from New York. The guy introduces himself as Dude, and this is my side man, Subdude. All right, straight ahead.
Probably end up spending twice as much money for gas a month than your rent.
We have those portable bathrooms because they're redoing the bathrooms at Luxor, and they're brutal. I wouldn't send anybody in there. I mean, rather than Guantanamo, that's what they should do, just make people spend 10 minutes in those portable bathrooms.
Hey, how's the heart attack?
I haven't had one in a while.
Yeah.
No, actually, the whole condition is very stable. Last time I saw my cardiologist, she's listening to my heart with a stethoscope and looks up at me and says, boring.
You gotta be regular to have regulars.
April Fool's Day.
Mm-hmm.
The baseball season starts today.
Yes.
The Final Four basketball tournament will be completed tomorrow.
Now that I didn't know.
My baseball fantasy league draft is tomorrow.
Oh, is that the dinner, the banquet?
No, that happens at the end of the year where, you know, they announced that we finished last.
Oh, well, you may not finish last.
Nah,
your fantasy league won't, for sure.
No, I don't think we're going to finish last this year. I mean, you can't lose them all.
Mm-hmm.
see it. You know, one of Red's housemates passed away. This is Ralph Edward Herring.
From?
From Missouri.
Fulton, Missouri.
Fulton, Missouri.
Where Winston Churchill and Harry Truman came in 1946.
A nice ensemble.
Yeah, well, I think I'm three hats today. It'll be a nice Sunday. Ouchie.
I bought Red the cowboy hat.
Okay.
For
Halloween.
For a Halloween.
Halloween. Okay.
All right, so now it turned out it was a little big. So what he wore as a gasket was a Marilyn Monroe wig. But, so you're one Marilyn Monroe wig short today, Red.
I know. He's an excellent cab driver. Very considerate. Patient. I don't get that too many cab drivers. How did I get you, Dennis?
You've never had me, and I don't even want you to start any rumors like that.
Well, this is the time to start that rumor.
Red, Red has a lot of medical things he has to take care of.
My doctor, Kenneth Mills, he says, Ed, you are my miracle child. Your CD count is 1,133, viral load undetectable. You see, I've been on the cocktail, the protease inhibitor, for 10 years.
Wow.
And it's saved my life.
Part of a group that tried to buy the Baltimore Orioles. They're rolling in dough. But also in effect, in part, it was all of that contributed to unhappiness. Money is not everything, I'll tell you that. I want to say can't buy me love, but that's not true. I think as a cab driver, my strength is bedside manner.
Oh, that driver, I figured that out.
Oh, it's gonna be a long, hot summer with a fat lip. I went to this poor guy at Billy's funeral, you know, and this memorial that they had for him. I looked around the room and I thought, oh God, the drugs that were done out of this group. I mean, literally, tons. God knows how I survived that. Still, I don't know. Mystical, magic. If I was having any kind of a life, I would say I was blessed. But it's not applicable.
Think getting busted saved your ass?
Probably.
I'm an ex-heroin addict, and
you're not alone.
I'm going up here to the Bart Clinic, and there'll be some real characters in this line up here. Tom, tell him about the methadone clinic and how it works while I dose, all right?
Okay.
All right, let him know.
How it works? Well, first of all, you have to become a drug addict, and when that happens, you get tired of the lifestyle you're living, and you come to a place like this, and they give you a synthetic narcotic, and you drink it as long as you feel better and feel like you can make it without it.
I don't know how I can really explain the feeling that a person has that has an addiction problem. It's something that a lot of people in this country have, and they don't really know how to deal with the people that are struggling with their issues or the pain that they have inside.
I came home from Nam, and it wasn't, it was better then, but the heroin was good too. But now, the heroin sucks, and you may go to bed one night and your arm is coming off, you know? So I best thing to do is get on methadone, you know?
Well, I did 13 21-day detox programs. That was like a vaccination that never took, you know. And then I got on maintenance. But from the day I got on, I mean, I knew that this wasn't going to be a long association. And I was determined to get off as soon as I got on.
Well, I've been on this stuff for 38 years.
I'm not on detox, I'm on maintenance, because I know if I don't have this, I'll be back on heroin.
We all just have to basically work real hard on each other and, you know, make things work. Because the way we're going now, we're all going to get picked off one at a time as an addict and die.
Driving celebrity around, huh? Dennis, all right. Mr. Bear Aspen, how you doing?
I'm having the time of my life. How about you, Howard?
You want to be a letter? What's going on?
No, I'm driving a cab.
Remember, I knew you went.
I know. I knew me when, too.
That's a guy I was in jail with.
Was it?
Yes.
Hey Dennis, is this the methadone clinic you used to go to?
No. But I went to a...
Ford Help, right?
No, a sister clinic, Bart Market.
I liked it better when this clinic was up on Gary, because you didn't have to come down here. Because right in here is a big, major heroin and crack dealing place down here.
This neighborhood is brutal. I went into this drug program to clean up, you know, and I learned to cop in every ghetto in the United States. I learned it. I made more connects in this drug program. You know, I let these people know that this does not have to be a lifetime ordeal, that it's absolutely possible to get off. But it's not easy, I really mean it. As you begin to diminish your dose, one's body really takes a beating. She goes and leaves flowers on her husband's grave, her father's grave, and the cat's grave. I ask her if the cat was Jewish. And she says, look at me. I said, well, cats, it's a Jewish name.
Diana, how are you? So-so, huh?
No, good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm thinking in the morning that I will not can come. So, wait a minute.
Yeah, no, take your time.
Because my movement is so badly. Monday is the seder, real seder.
Mm-hmm.
And I go to my niece, you was once, on Fulton and Third.
Uh-huh.
You remember?
Yeah, you know, yes. What time are you going Monday?
I think 6 o'clock.
6 in the evening?
Yes.
I might be able to give you a ride.
Oh, good.
Yeah. She doesn't realize, you know, if I didn't need the money, I would drive her for free. She's just such a dear. So now we're going to farmer's market, right?
Yes, to farmer's
On Hyde Street.
Here on, where is the library?
Yeah.
Yes.
But by Civic Center.
I don't know the name of the...
By Civic Center.
Yes.
Yes.
You don't get good. It's in this side.
No, everything's there. Good. It's on Hyde Street.
Here?
Yeah.
Ah,
have I ever failed you?
I mean, no, honestly, no, never.
Never.
It's not displayed. They are not here, the people out here. I needed to found out the place.
Okay, I'm coming.
You heard 5 pounds at first.
Okay. If she said 1/2 pound, I heard 1/2 pound.
Yes, you know what?
Hey, that's it.
All you gotta say, all you gotta do is 2 words. Yes, dear. Yes.
Exactly. I don't know. As we go into Chinatown, on the left-hand side, you're going to see this Israeli cafe. And this is really... And he bought several cases of Manischewitz wine, and it's a table wine in this Chinese restaurant. I thought, oh, yikes. I had these three gay women in a car. I got a chance to use my best line. Where to, lesbos? Really, it whacked me with a newspaper. Sign of the times. I mean, you could get in trouble then, but now it was funny. Yeah, the human jukebox. You put money in, and this flap opens up in the jukebox, and he gives you an ounce of pot. He's got caught on Fisherman's Wharf, selling to a cop. That bus looks like it came from Bangalore. Dave has this idea that where to go, and I would say we'll listen to him. I just have so much regard for this guy because I know what he does with his spare time is he really looks after the cab drivers. Try it.
If you're a day driver, you pick up a lot of folks who go to the need to go to the doctor. Business people going to the airport, and so you get to serve those people. Also, San Francisco is a beautiful city, and just by osmosis, you're gonna pick up on the beauty. There's another form of beauty too, which is this is the birthplace of the United Nations, and there's a lot of karma here, and the charter was signed in June of 1945 in the Veterans Building, right next to the Opera House.
And that was in answer to the question of how long you've been driving a cab.
Yeah,
now,
you ask another question. Hey, Dennis, how long you've been driving a cab?
About 6 years total.
It's early. It's only the third inning.
So, by the way, speaking of the end, what are the A's doing? Are the A's playing the Giants again today?
They are.
All right, so you're gonna share the back seat with Sylvia. And behave yourself.
Good day, troops.
Hey, Red.
All right, so we're going to Clipper and where?
Sanchez.
Clipper and Sanchez, yes.
My psychiatrist said, from what little I told him about my parents and my brother, and my background, that sex was never discussed at the dinner table or anywhere. Taboo. So now that I'm an adult, I say foul words sometimes.
All right, so tell me this, Red. Are you actually going to go to church?
Says all are welcome.
We're the only all accepted. There was a, like a drag queen or a transgender, we used to meet down on Valencia. And before the service, she'd be on her haunches, have a mirror, shaving a beard, a man's beard. And she'd say, she'd be in Safeway or a bus stop, and little kids would nudge her, Mama, guess him. Mama, what's that? It's a man trying to look like a woman. Sabrina.
Hi. Tastefully staying off the Mercedes. Oops. God, I did a better job than I thought.
She's an absolute killer.
She's really such a sweetie.
What's her name?
Angela.
I should keep myself straight about this one. She's 27 years old, and I'm not so spoiled or selfish. I've already had a life. But she really is a charmer, and I love hanging out with her. But honestly, it's out of regard for her. I'm 63 years old. I'm not the guy for her.
You got a late start?
We're cougars in training. Cougars in training. How are you?
Great, you guys cutting across? You taking a shortcut here?
Basically. We're just looking for some young men to coug out with.
We're chicken hawks.
You know what a cougar is, right?
Somebody who eats a chicken hawk?
No.
No, we are chicken
hawks. Older ladies that go for a younger man. Does it make you hot? I'm sorry. We love you. Look at our tails.
Can we go to Pacific between Jones and Taylor?
Pacific between Jones and Taylor.
Yeah, yes. Are you getting my tattoo?
I was hoping we were going to say Reno.
Candace Beta Breakers.
It's enough information. For me, I'm old. The candle's flickering.
You know, we think, you know, you can have a drink a little and then burn off the calories you're drinking.
The race gets easier as you go because you're no longer holding 2 6-packs.
Right.
Please, can we get in the back? We need to get over to the race.
Well,
how many
are you?
As many as you can fit. Can we just please get a ride over there?
Break, go, fade up, break, here we go.
We need you to be the breaker. Drive us, please.
Let us in the car. I'm not going to lie. I'm wearing a singlet.
We need to go to Bay of the Breakers. I would eat that right now. Right now. Right now. We need to go. Where is it?
We're lost.
You're lost. I'm way off the hook with methadone and then smoked crack on top of it.
The methadone just took the edge off and you added a little crack
I was going for that medical speedball.
Almost from the first day I met Ryan, I thought, this is a cowboy who's, down deep, really a nice guy.
Yeah.
And by the way, that was nice to meet your girlfriend.
Yeah, she's sleeping.
She's really all right. I'm proud of you. This is the good news.
Yeah. I don't get aggressive around her. She goes, you're not going to get violent around me. I don't even want to see you mad. I was like, all right, so I have to watch what I say. And all. But that's a good thing, though. From being out here in this concrete jungle for so long. See, Dad committed suicide when she was 12. She lived in the National Hotel when she was like 12, 13. Then she went to the Donnelly, then she went to the Civic Center. All is a, you know, as a minor, this lady that owned all those hotels became like her guardian or whatever. As one hotel got off the hook and it wasn't safe for my girlfriend, Becca, she'd move her. She used to live right here at the Civic Center there Hotel. She was up there one day and she showed me the room that she lived in, and this guy named Benny that we both know pushed another guy right out the window onto the floor as the lady who owns all these hotels was walking up. I said, how long did that last? How long did you stay in the hotel? She said about 2 more days. You know, shit changes.
Ah, but she seems like a solid citizen.
She is a solid citizen. She's good for me.
Yeah,
good,
absolutely. Down on the Embarcadero. I mean, if the weather's really nice, the stretch is so jam-packed, it's really hard to negotiate. And yes, there are fares, but it's no fun driving. And God knows I'm not in driving a cab to make money, to make a little money and have a good, and enjoy myself, take advantage of the low overhead in my life. Kevin, it's going good. We won big yesterday. Yeah, it's funny. That's 3 different versions. I had us losing 38-31. Mumford had us losing 38-32. So, yeah, same neighborhood. But we won big yesterday. Andrew Jones, he hit a home run. Played in the Huskow. Yeah, I mean, honestly, we were on a ranch. The dorm, as it were, was only about, was less than 100 feet from the, from home plate. We literally rolled out of the dorm onto the baseball diamond. Place was sort of meant for me. Girl, how you fix your softballs?
I got some. How many you need?
Probably a couple.
A couple? All right, you want them down?
No. As long as they're in the bag, as they say.
All right, Paul.
And they're paying me off. This is a big payoff. Watch this. See
really?
That? Now, they never lose a game. Even as bad as they are. Love you guys. You guys take care.
All right, thanks, Merle. I appreciate it very much.
The payoff's been made.
So, Dennis, you finally got some balls, huh?
Hey, who's the comic here?
Sure, I'm not taking the plastic off.
One down.
Ever.
One down. Good, watch back, buddy.
So, Dennis, you got any special preparations for the game or what?
No, usually I bring my oxygen bottle, but special preparations, yeah, we throw the ball around a little.
Dennis has been around long enough, though, he gets out of the sack warm.
Last out, buys the beer. So
the
that's
week.
Why I have tactically not penciled myself in the lineup.
So how long have you been playing ball with Dennis?
30 years.
Wow. Incredible.
Hate to admit it.
Really? Has it gotten worse or what?
Oh, yeah, he's gotten worse. His skills have, he used to be a five-tool player, now he's a no-tool player.
So what do you guys...
But he has aged. Yeah. Gracefully at that.
Yeah, well, once upon a time, we had a fabulous team. We have a very good team now for a bunch of geezers. You'll see. I mean, we can play. I'm the flaw.
We got Ray, Mike Malone, Kim Malone, Steve Smith, John Graz, Aaron, and Dennis Breit's making a cameo for, Aaron.
All right, you can't be out here, Bob. It's dangerous. That's our pitcher. He's left-handed.
Can't trust lefties, huh?
Precisely. Look at Stalin.
Come on, Tom, come on!
That's out of play!
This is worth it. I mean, this just calling balls and strikes is a show in itself.
Hi. This is Sue. Sat behind a big old mahogany desk. Walked in, I had to sit in the lobby before I got a chance to see him. Showed me in to see Mr. Breit. And we sat down, we talked baseball.
Was that my name? Mr. Breit? Oh, yeah.
We talked baseball for an hour, and we've been fast friends ever since.
That's right.
Been some good times.
Here we go, start us.
Not too many base hits, but some good times.
It's brutal.
All right, Ray Bach. How are you?
Yeah. Oh, no, I told you I was going to tell you this deaf joke. Oh, I did tell you that, right?
Right.
What's this?
What's that?
Pasteurized milk. Pasteurized milk. 're legal for pot. I mean, it's nothing, and they're legal. I'm sure they're licensed to sell it.
Of course.
If I didn't have such a checkered past, I think I would be in the pot club business.
It makes you mellow, you know. Kind of worries can fly away a little more.
Oh, that's
relieves stress. Stress kills.
Oh, you got the. Got the slogans down. Stress kills, give me pot. No appetite, give me pot. What else?
See, I always have an appetite, so I can't use that as an excuse.
You mean?
My ex said I just want it for recreational purposes.
And?
I didn't give him an
answer. What
would
that be, when you're ski jumping?
When you're horny and want to play around. And it always takes two to tango.
I got it. Oh, we're cool.
It's called Granddaddy XO. That's the best probably in the city.
Do you remember that plastic bottle you gave me from the pot club?
Yeah.
I had to give a urine specimen. It's almost identical to the other jar. Okay. and I filled the one from the pot club and brought it in. I know.
Oh, yeah, that was good.
So, yes, except the lab looks at the jar and says, you're not shooting, are you? All right, so I'm going to see you tomorrow. I'll drop that lighter off.
Okay. Thanks, guys.
So I heard this discussion about George Bush and his brother Jeb, you know, as they relate to their father, Herbert Walker Bush, you know, and somebody said that George Bush W's nickname was the evil of two lessers. And there you have it. That was secure at our toe. Put myself in a position where I could lose that place. I mean, I had a lifetime lease on it. I was leading the life of Riley. No substitute for experience. I mean, what an experience. Really, CEO. I had a Q clearance once upon a time. You know, I toured Lawrence Livermore Lab. It showed me all the happenings out there. And then Pelican Bay.
We got a couple of great bridges in the city. The Golden Gate Bridge. We got the Bay Bridge. Those are sister bridges, by the way. Bay Bridge, 1936. Golden Gate, May of 1937. And so this is a memorial over here to what happened across the street at the Autofred building over there. And these are the guys who did the real lifting, the real work like Dennis does. Sits on his butt in the cab, takes the people to the hospital, takes the old lady to the graveyard, and then they want to screw him out of his benefits, miniaturize the benefits, compartmentalize it, have the corporations, the taxi corporations, wash their hands of any responsibility towards the people who bring the money to the window and pay for their wives, their kids, and so forth. Just as a wild and crazy thought. That's what's going on.
Dennis is one of a kind. I even said that when Rebecca was in the car. Yeah, Dennis, I would have never thought about it the first time I jumped in his cab. I would have never thought about it.
When are you going to quit smoking? Right?
Today. This is my last day of smoking.
Okay, can we tell your cardiologist that?
Absolutely. I'm going to see my doctor on Wednesday, and I want to look her in the eye and say I quit.
Even if you're lying?
No, I won't lie to her. I can't.
Why, she's your lifeline?
Nah, she just has so much integrity, and I have to say, she's probably got more invested in my health than I do.
What's this is all about?
Methadone, man.
Methadone?
What do you think about methadone?
Well, it's better than that heroin. The heroin they bring across the border is full of viral infection, and it's killing people. You know what I'm saying? You shoot that stuff in your arm, the next thing you know, your arm will fall off. So I suggest everybody stay away from that hair rod.
Hey, Dennis.
Yeah?
What was the deal with the guy who we drove to the methadone clinic? What was his name?
Ryan.
Ryan.
Yeah, where'd I just picked him up as a fare one day. And I told him I was a graduate. He is since the cable car is off the cable. In fact, he's missing in action. He hadn't been home in days. But even before he'd been missing, I mean, he really he gave up his program.
I will call you to tell you precisely what hour.
Uh-huh.
Yes?
Yeah, no, no problem.
Oh, good. Good.
Have you ever heard Denny play the piano?
Oh, yeah.
He's an accomplished pianist, almost.
Rachmaninoff.
Yeah. Verdi.
Chopin.
Tchaikovsky.
So there's an incredible convergence of things happening now.
Uh-huh.
Today is Palm Sunday, right?
Yes.
Passover's tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And
happy Pesach.
Today, thank you. That's like saying happy Ramadan.
What do you think, Bob?
What's that?
Well, no, here.
Put it under his jacket?
Yeah, we'll see if it works. Oh, coffee. Good, good. A funny thing happened to me on the way down here tonight. A man fell out of a three-story window and landed right at my feet. I bent over and I said, "What happened, pal?" He says, "I don't know. I just got here myself."
That's real good, Dennis.
Talking about cowboys. Two cowboys are sitting on a fence. One cowboy says to the other, he says, "Say, Tex, are you really from Texas?" He says, "No, I'm from Louisiana." He said, "Why do they call you Tex?" He says, "I shoot the first guy who calls me Louise."
Nice, Dennis. Real good.
All right, how do you drink from these?
Okay.
An ugly baby that when I was born, the doctor slapped my mother. I hopped in the cab and told him to take me where the action was. He took me to my house. My wife likes to talk to me after sex. Now she calls me from hotels.
Nice, Dennis. Real nice.
I have this philosophy, if you're going to spend a couple of minutes with me, I'm going to leave you laughing. And I really mean it. And I want to cheer myself up. Honest, I never want this job to be drudgery.
That means you can keep smoking?
Not exactly. She's threatened to strangle me. She said, "Your smoking is really dangerous for your health." I said, "Really?" She said, "Yeah, because I'm going to strangle you if you don't stop." Not that interesting, huh? Here comes baseball.